I am relaxed. I am relaxed. Fill your own cup. Hello, my name is Mother Moose. We're going to take a look inside of our Boost box today and see what affirmations and social scenarios we have in here that we can learn from. See what we've got in the box today. I am calm and at peace. I'm going to take three deep, long breaths right now. Calm. When I feel calm, I can hang out with a friend, smell the fresh air, or cozy up and relax. Those are three things that you can do when you feel calm. When I feel relaxed, I can close my eyes, appreciate the moment, have gratitude, and get comfortable. Are you calm? Being calm means you slow down and take a deep breath and feel peaceful. If you were angry, you would take a deep breath and count to 10. This is what makes you calm. Say out loud, I am calm. Otis is calm. Taking time to rest is important for Otis. It helps him to gain energy and be in a good mood. So that's why sleep is so important. How would you feel if the person sitting behind you keeps tapping your chair with his foot? How would that make you feel? You could either yell and scream at him for tapping your chair, or you could kindly ask him to stop. What do you think is the best choice? I think you should ask him to stop, and if not, then that's why you have elders and teachers that you can go to get some extra help if someone's kind of rebelling, right? But you never get into the same annoying energy that the other person is in, because then it just becomes a huge fight, right? So, how would you feel if you forgot your lunch at home? How would you feel? I think you might feel, well, I would feel disappointed because you might have to wait for maybe a parent to bring your second lunch or maybe a teacher to get you a lunch in the meantime or a snack. But a way that you can deal with that is to be patient. To ask for a small snack in the meantime, maybe one of your friends can give you a snack or a juice box or something, right? So be patient while you're dealing with the situation and ask for help. Don't just sit there like this guy's just kind of sitting there. Ask for help and stay calm, and usually the situation will get worked out, right? If you're screaming and having a tantrum, it'll take longer. So this is why it's so important to stay calm. So this is a self-care card. It's a way to take care of yourself. So this has to do with making decisions, right? So you have the decision here whether you're gonna get so angry and scream at this person, scream at your parent for forgetting your lunch, or at yourself, be angry at yourself, or scream at this guy for tapping your chair. But you have the choice to make the decision to use the tools that you're learning from this boost box to stay calm and at peace. Because when you stay calm and at peace, the situation, whatever chaotic situation you're in, will get solved so much faster and so much more peacefully. So the affirmation is, I am calm and at peace. I'm going to take three deep, long breaths right now. I am calm and at peace. This is my friend Annette. She is very outgoing and she's very good at standing up for what she believes in. I admire her courage and her bravery. I admire her ability to use her voice and stick to what she believes in. We're best friends and we get along very well. We embrace our similarities and teach each other about our different strengths and differences. I, on the other hand, I'm very quiet, but very nurturing and loving. I am funny and great at knowing when my friends are sad and cheering them up. This is how we use our skills to support each other and learn from each other. So together we make such a great team. Friends that are different but love each other. So we have a list of all the different chakras here. So we have I understand, I see, I talk, I love, I feel, I do, and I am. Okay, so my friend Annette here, she has an amazing throat chakra. She's good at speaking up and expressing, you know, I talk, right? So she's good at communicating very well. So that's a skill that she has. So everybody is good at different things. And some of us are stronger in certain areas. So we all have to work harder in other areas. So that's why it's good to have friends that are different, because we can teach each other, right? And that's how we learn and we grow. So as for me, I'm totally green because I have a big heart chakra. My heart chakra is aligned. It represents I love, and I'm very loving and nurturing. So that is my beautiful skill. And I've got purple hearts all over me because I have a great understanding and I'm able to see and feel how people are feeling before they even are. And that's what makes me such a great friend. So Annette has I am, right? So this has to do with your root chakra. So her hearts are red because she's very confident. Even though we're both kids, she's very confident and she knows exactly what she believes in, and she stands up for her friends and for her family. And I really admire her for that. So we are so different, but together we make such a great team. So we've got two more things. We have an affirmation here of things that you can do if you're feeling frustrated, right? So the first suggestion is walk around your home sending air hugs to your favorite things and say, I am glad you're here. So this is a great way to show gratitude by really enjoying the things that you already have, right? Before asking for more things, enjoy the things that you have and think about how much you appreciate those things and how much they make you happy every day. Sometimes when you see things all the time, you kind of lose appreciation. So take the time to go around and say, I am glad you're here. So that's one thing you can do that can get you back into a positive energy. So here is something else that can help your self-esteem. You can draw a heart and fill the heart up with things that you love to do. So again, going back to thinking of things that you can do on a daily basis, right? Instead of thinking of things that you can't do and things that you can't have, think of the things that you already have and you already love, and make a list of that and remind yourself of how lucky you are. So I made my heart here. I made a big one because I have a lot of things that I love. So I have on here, for example, swimming. I've got my bathing suit, and this can be a fun thing you can do with your friends too. Like a gratitude exercise. So you can put your birthday, if your birthday is really fun and you really have good memories on your birthday. If you like playing baseball with your friends in the summertime, or if you live in a hot place. I love reading. I love nature, to be out in nature and biking, right? So that's kind of to do with nature too. If you're passing nature, you get to see all the beautiful plants. And I love music, and I love spring, and of course I love movies. So here is my big heart of things that I love. So this is something easy that you can try at home, an activity you can do with your friends, or even it's great to do with your parents because you might not know all the things that they love to do. So it's a good way to get to know them. And it's an easy way, inexpensive, to get to know your parents or your friends or people that are close to you, right? So that's something that you can try along with going around your house and saying, I am glad you're here. You can even tell your parents that too, because they would probably really appreciate it. So those are some tools that you can use when you're feeling frustrated to get back into gratitude and to help you get calm and relaxed.
It's banana cocoa.